have not a lot of time to make a revolution.
He's gone backwards again.
Fabio Quattro is Lewis Bengtsson, another absolute nightmare.
The future right now is not in my hands, it's in Yamaha hands. Of course, I would prefer to stay with Yamaha, but if they don't make what I want and a competitive bike, I will have to consider myself moving for 2025. Mentally has been tough, it's difficult. When you are fighting for 3 years in a row for the championship, wins podium for every single race, and you fight for one podium and looks like you made it.
Quartararo wasn't happy coming across the line because, of course, Martin just sighed across the front of him.
Is Fabio Quartararo's unhappiness justified?
You know, sometimes a rider can cover a little bit the problems, but arrive one moment where the problems are bigger and I cannot do nothing. Basically, it's 3 years we have a really similar bike. It's not a massive change and we cannot make some improvements, so for the next year and for the future, it's all in Yamaha hands to make a better bike and see how it's going. It was not a positive test for us. I'm on the bike. I can say what I feel. We had a 1 hour meeting. We were more or less 20 people in the meeting. And I told straight away to these 20 people that I was not happy, that we have to improve. I regressed a lot. But I will be happy if they do half of what I ask. Half next year and half for 2025, I could be happy. If you really want to be professional and try to be competitive for 2024, you have to take a lot of risk. The others will make a step forward again, and if we don't do it, we will be even worse than this year. And to be walking on the edge of everything. Walking on the edge of the rules, walking on the edge of the potential of the bike. Don't be that safe.
Here is Fabio Quartararo then on the Yamaha.
Quartararo was a good half second quicker on the last lap. He's joining this dice.
That's beautifully done.
It can be a winning project if we have a stronger mentality.